Hello students, in the previous module we had discussed, I have given you an introduction to the different forms, the elements which we can use. So we have already looked at that we can create forms for our radio buttons, check boxes, text boxes, drop boxes, lots of different controls. In this module, I am going to show you how we can make a input type is equal to text control and see how we can actually submit the input collected in that text box on the server. So let's get started. What I'm going to do is I'm going to create a heading tag which I've already introduced you in the previous module, and in the heading tag I'm going to give the information, or basically the name information, as the heading. In order to create a form, we discussed we have to use the form attribute, and since we want to collect all the information and submit this information, we will be using an action tag. So in the action tag, what am I doing? I have given an action saying action ph and dot php. So what we are saying, whatever information we have collected should be submitted on to the server on this particular page. So that is what the action tag is doing. Now within this, we will create a label, and we will create a label for, let's give it a name, first name of the student, and the label that will appear on the screen is first name with a colon. I am going to end my label tag, and because I want the next information should come on the next line, I am using a br tag. I am using another tag now, which is input tag, and I'm using input type is equal to text, because what I want is I want actually a text box. I'm going to give a ID. We have discussed what is an ID. It is a unique identifier that you give. Let's say if I want to by default populate it with Tim, I will give the value as Tim. But if you do not want to by default populate it, please feel free to ignore this value attribute. I also want to use a button, so I'm using input type is equal to button, and what I can do is I can use a button if I just want the information to be stored without submitting. But if I want to submit, I will use input type is equal to submit, and I will close the tag after giving the value, which is the submit. So whatever value that you give will be appearing on the button. I'm going to close this, and I will also close the form element. I'm introducing another paragraph where I'm saying this is how a form is created, and I'm going to end my paragraph tag. Make sure the way you have closed all the other forms, you also close your form tag. Make sure you have closed your heading tag and the paragraph tag also. I'm going to save my code now to see the final output, how this form has got generated. So let's see how the test.html file gives me the output. Now if I compare the input and the output that we have written, we'll see that we have got the heading that we gave in this particular notepad. Whatever heading we gave has come here. We have given the first name as the label, and whatever first name label we have given, it has come here. We had given a by default value, if you remember, as Tim. So this value by default is coming as Tim, right? And we had a submit button also. So if let's say we want the user to also enter the value, we can always enter the value and we can click on the submit. Now remember, these HTML pages are, for now, we are creating static pages. But any information that we want to send up, we can always integrate it with the JavaScript. And obviously to make our pages, we can also use the CSS. All right. So this is how we have learned that we can create a form with two controls. One control is the first name, which is our text box. The second control is the submit, which is a submit button. In the couple of next modules, we will pick up one control at one time, and we will see how we can incorporate it in the form. So stay tuned for the next module. Bye-bye.